just on this year's Warped Tour, what were some of the highlights?
We got to play main stage a couple times, and that was really, really, really cool, because it's just awesome to share a stage with people like Bad Religion and NoFX and be a part of that whole thing. Just like meeting lots of new people, a lot of new bands that I'd never met before, and being able to see the guys from Bad Religion walking around and see the guys from NoFX walking around, and pretty much shared a bus with the early November, so it was a good time though. But I had fun mostly after the show was over, and there's like a big camp and everybody just hangs out and parties, so that was probably the most fun part.
What is a typical day for you when you're on tour?
Mostly, we're in the van, so we just wake up, depending on how far we are away from the place. Go to Denny's, get to the show, probably watch a ton of DVDs. Last time we were on tour, we watched Freaks and Geeks a lot. Show up, load in, sound check, wait around for 6 hours until the show starts, and just pretty much hang out and just bullshit with whoever we're on tour with. And just, it's like most of it is just waiting around just to play and stuff like that. But other than that, we're driving most of the time, because you got to drive sometimes 10 hours to the next show.
This is the first time you had a bus?
The first time we had a bus was actually a drive-through tour last year. We shared it with Alistair and a couple other people, and then we had a bus on the Warped Tour we shared with Early November. And then for this tour, we're just sharing with Mike Hemp.
Recently you moved to Vagrant Records. How did this decision come about?
We got picked up by Geffen about a year ago in August. Gave them our CD. They liked the CD. They thought it was a very good CD. They just didn't think it was a radio CD. And they wanted us to record, some radio songs. And we said we didn't want to go in the studio, back into the studio, because it already should have come out by then. We said that we didn't want to do anything like that, and we just kind of worked out a way where we could go to Vagrant, because we felt that was the best label for our band at this point in time.
You have a new album coming out on September 7th. What was your favorite song to record?
Favorite song to record? Probably Lady in the Blue Dress, because I don't know, for some reason I was real pissed off that day. I don't really remember about what, but I let it all out in the studio, and I think when you listen to that song versus a lot of the other songs, it just, there's something different about the way I sang on that, because I don't really know why. I think it was just the time that it happened. It was late at night, and I don't know, I was just confused about a lot of things, so I put a lot into that song and I came out really good.
When making the new album, did you do anything different than the last one?
Oh yeah, of course, because in the first time we recorded, they were just our demos. Our EP is pretty much all our demos. I mean, we never expected that to go as far as it did. So, we just went in there and did it rough, not really thinking about the songs, rewriting the songs, doing different things with them. We didn't really use sound-wise, we didn't have the same things we had in the new album, just with the production, and that the way the quality of the studio we were in and the quality of just everything down to the equipment we were using. So, everything was totally different. It was completely different working with a producer who had a lot of experience with a lot of bands and had been around a lot. So it was really good for us. It was different then.
How would you describe your music to someone who's never heard it before?
I don't know, I don't know how to explain that, and I always feel weird when I ask bands. I'm like, what do you guys sound like? And they're like, well, we sound like, the best way to say it is I think we sound like a bunch of bands. I think we sound like Saves the Day, mixed with Fairweather and Thursday, mixed with, I don't know, I think that would be the best, I think that would be the best thing, Saves the Day, Fairweather, and Thursday. If you like those, Take Back Sunday, if you like stuff like that, I think that you'd be into our band.
Do you have any funny tour stories or embarrassing moments you'd like to share?
I rip my pants a lot. I don't know why. Dickies supposedly makes indestructible pants, but for some reason I've ripped three pairs of them, and sometimes they'll just split, and I'll just rip them off and run around like an asshole. But embarrassing, I forget the lyrics. I've forgotten the lyrics at, like, a couple really big shows, like Skate and Surf. It's not this year, last year. I, like, just forgot the words in the middle of 187 because we had been in the studio for 2 months, and I wasn't thinking about those songs at all, and we weren't playing them. I mean, it was the first show we had played in about 2-3 months, and it was just such a big show, and there was so much adrenaline, and it was so exciting that I just kind of was, like, just totally lost my train of thought and was like, that was real embarrassing for me to screw it up. But it wasn't really even a big deal, just for me, myself, kind of embarrassing.
What was the first song you wrote as a band?
Dreaming of Reality.
What do you enjoy most about being in a band?
I think, like, playing the show. Playing the show, because that's what I wanted to be in a band for, was to play shows, you know, to be able to play in front of a group of people, and it only gets better. I mean, when people start to, like, notice your songs, it just gets even better, because, you know, there's, like, a connection, and you get sort of a reaction, you feed off the crowd, and it's just, like, one of the best things that I've ever done in my life, that I can, you know, like, playing a show is up there with any other experience I've ever had, you know, pretty much, I mean, everything else kind of just sucks. Being on tour, like, just, you know, it's like you're away from home, and, you know, it's cool at first, but when you're doing it for, like, 2 years, you're like, I just want to play the show, because driving sucks. Driving sucks. I hate being in the van and driving. I like getting to the show, and once you get to the show, it's like, all right, everything's cool, but getting there sucks.
If you weren't in a band, what do you think you'd be doing?
No idea. I don't even think about that, because I hope that never happens. I hope I can just be in a band for the rest of my life. I have no idea.
Where do you get your inspirations for your songwriting?
Just, like, everyday things, I guess. I mean, just certain things that affect me. Just people that, for the new stuff we've been writing, I mean, more like, for Let It Fall, just kind of like, I was confused about where I was and how I ended up being in a band and getting such an amazing chance, and why it was me and not anyone else, and I kind of, like, tore myself apart for that, because I kind of felt that I wasn't worthy, and I still don't. I still think that, like, there's so many other people out there that deserve it more than me, and, you know, so that's something I kind of, like, write a lot about, and I read a lot of different authors and, you know, poets, and just kind of, like, see their perspective on the way the world works and the way life is, and just that. Pretty much I read a lot of philosophy, and that's what a lot of my songs are about, and that's why I don't think a lot of people understand what I'm talking about and think that my lyrics might be kind of just stupid and not make sense, because I don't think a lot of people think about that stuff. I don't think a lot of people are really into that, so I don't expect them to really understand what I'm saying, you know, because my songs aren't about, like, one or two of them on the new album are about, like, a girl, maybe, but, like, not even really, like, that might be the topic, but that's not the underlying meaning of the whole song, so, I don't think people really, at least, you know, for this kind of scene, I don't think kids really get into that. I think that it's gotta be straight, it's gotta be real straightforward, or else it's not gonna make sense.
What do you do in your spare time?
When I'm at home?
Yeah.
I hang out with my girlfriend and I sit in my room and watch TV. And I don't go anywhere. I don't want to go anywhere. I just want to sit there and do nothing. Because I'm always out and about doing stuff constantly all the time. So I just like to chill out and do nothing.
What's in your CD player right now?
Promise Ring, Nothing Feels Good. Not a Surf, Let Go. What else is that? Jawbreaker, Dear You, I listened to that the other day. And, what else did I just fucking listen to? I'll sleep to it every night. I can't even think. Appleseed Cast, the new Appleseed Cast, Two Conversations.
If you were invisible for a day, where would you go and what would you do?
I don't know. I'd like to probably see what people say about me behind my back. I think that would be always interesting. See what people say when I'm not around. Just like that. I was always wondering what people really thought of me like that, because you don't really know. I mean, I think that would be something I would do.
Do you ever play pranks on each other or the bands you tour with.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Hidden in Plainview, we shit in a box, and we wrote on it, like kind of like a fan had, you know, baked them cookies or something. We wrote, like, from a girl, and we put it outside their bus, and they picked it up, and they brought it on their bus, and they found out it was shit. So, that's funny. I thought that was pretty fucking hilarious.
What's your favorite song to play live?
I mean, right now, I mean, I can't really say because we haven't really played a ton of the new songs on the new album. But 187, I like that a lot just because I like the way that everybody sings along, and it's just like a really all-crowd participation, and it's usually end with that, and it's just, I don't know, I just like the way that it's slow at first and then crazy at the end.
That's
like,
actually my favorite song.
Yeah, I think that's everyone's favorite song to hear live, I think, for the most part.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
I don't know. I have no idea. I try not to think about that like that. I'd rather think about where I'm going to be tomorrow, just because I don't know where I'm going to be in 5 years, so I don't even want to think about it. I don't agree with planning ahead that far. You know, plan ahead 6 months, that makes sense, but I have no idea. I couldn't tell you where I would be in 5 years.
Do you have any advice for aspiring musicians?
Don't go out and get a manager first, and don't go out and, you know, do a lot of bands are just, you know, going out and getting these managers that aren't managers. They're just people who want to be managers exactly like you want to be in a band, and they're not going to do anything for you, and it's not even going to help. And especially don't pay them money and don't sign any contracts. But most importantly, just keep writing music and always just keep writing songs constantly all the time, because that's the only way to get any better. And be simple with your, I mean, depending on what kind of band you're in, I mean, obviously, but, like, at first, I think a band needs to be simple. They need to, like, grasp the concept of writing a song first before they can manipulate it and do different things with it. And that's the most important thing, is the songwriting, is the musicianship and the songwriting and how they're put together. That's basically it, because, I mean, it all comes down to your songs. I mean, there's nothing else. You can't say, like, well, we didn't do well because anything, you know, like, you need your songs to be tight and to be very, very good, you know. So that's the most important thing, is that I don't get to just keep writing songs and just keep doing it over and over and over again, and you know, trying to, you know, take, just look at how other bands write their songs and be like, what are they doing that we're not? Because, you know, these bands are there and we're here. What are they doing that we're not? Don't copy them, but just understand, like, theory-wise, how they're formulating their song.
Do you have any questions for me?
I don't know. Where are you from?
Here.
Oh, I once went to school here at Nazareth. I came up here in the winter, and I couldn't handle it. It's too far away. Too far away from Jersey. It's like 5 hours. No, it's like 5 hours.
The weather's shitty here in the winter.
Oh, it's real bad. Real bad.
And it hasn't even been warm until, like, today.
Really?
Been like raining and cold.
That's alright though. I mean, this is nice weather. If it doesn't get any hotter than this, that'd be awesome. Well, cool.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah.